Interracial marriages became legal nationwide in 1967. 16 states, from Delaware to Texas, did not permit interracial marriages until the Supreme Court decision. The same year, Guess Who's Coming to Dinner was released in theaters.
I haven't even told you his name. Mommy, it's John Wade Prentice. Isn't that a lovely name?
John Wade.
Joanna Prentice, I'll be.
His liberal message about racial harmony, and of course the overtly about miscegenation and marriage between the races, was shocking to some, but it came really at the right time, as did the Defiant Ones, with the rise of the modern civil rights movement.
Interracial relationships are far more socially acceptable today than ever before. Statistics on interracial marriages reveal that they are on the rise. According to the Pew Research Center's Census Bureau statistics, a record 14.6% of all new marriages in the United States in 2008 were between spouses of a different race or ethnicity from one another. This compares to 8% of all current marriages, regardless of when they occurred. Studies like Judith Todd's Attitudes Towards Interracial Dating reveal that American attitudes towards interracial relationships is improving.
For the first part of our experiment, we used Qualtrics.com to create a questionnaire that we posted on Amazon.com's Mechanical Turk. 30 participants from around the world answered our survey. Our survey determined explicit behaviors towards interracial couples by asking questions from J.B. McConaughey's Modern Racism Scale and Emery Bogardus's Social Distance Scale. The Modern Racism Scale measures reactions to African Americans as threats to the traditional values and economic status of whites. The Social Distance Scale examines how close or distant in-group members feel towards out-group members. We chose 14 of the questions from these two scales and added several filler questions to spread throughout the survey.
For our field study, the second component of our experiment, we set out to measure the public's implicit behaviors towards heterosexual interracial relationships versus heterosexual white relationships. We wanted to see if hostile racism of the 1960s has morphed into aversive racism in modern times. To measure participants' reactions to interracial relationships, we conducted our research on Tejon Street in Colorado Springs.
Sam played the boyfriend while Trina and Priscilla played the girlfriend. First, Sam and Priscilla approached 16 different people, 8 men and 8 women. Then Sam and Trina approached 8 men and 8 women. In total, there were 32 target participants. All participants targeted were Caucasian and age 25 to 45.
We decided to measure the immediacy behavior of these target participants.
Wirtz, Zanna, and Cooper define immediacy as the extent to which communication behaviors enhance closeness and nonverbal interaction with one another.
We used their model to conduct our experiment. We asked for directions to Josh and John's, a local ice cream parlor located less than 3 blocks from our study area.
When asking for directions and restaurant recommendations, I measured eye contact and the angle people faced. Priscilla and Trina measured the distance of the targets from the couple. As a second measurement of distance, Samistine and Melissa sat nearby and photographed the target's feet. They also observed body language and comfort levels of the target participants.
Research by Lalonde et al. In 2007 shows that threat to social dominance orientation of a white individual would cause them to be more comfortable with a white relationship than an interracial relationship.
We wanted to test if interracial couples and non-interracial couples would influence implicit behaviors differently in participants of the field experiment. We also asked how do explicit attitudes in the questionnaire differ from the implicit attitudes of the participants in the field experiment. We hypothesized that the interracial couple would receive less implicit behavior and receive recommendations of less expensive restaurants. We also predicted that the questionnaire would reveal explicit prejudice against interracial couples more from Republicans than Democrats.
I think if you did, and if any of those issues were related to race, I think it would be because people were uncomfortable with you and Trina being together. Especially because Trina, while she is a black woman, she's Trina. She's not light-skinned, she doesn't have long hair, she's not super thin. So there's a way in which she's not conforming to a certain kind of aesthetic that might make the interracial thing more palpable or palatable, excuse me, for certain people. So I think she might conjure up a lot of emotions just because she's not fitting any sort of norm.
I guess I might hypothesize that when you are with Trina, you're gonna get a little bit more of this. I would think that is probably a predictable, subtle, subconscious, unconscious reaction that people would do trying to figure you out. And that is what they're trying to do, even though they would want to say in conversations that they never want to be trying to figure you out. I think that would still happen.
A few participants pretended as if I was not talking to them and tried walking on. If they had to interact with Sam and me, the target would make an excuse in order to distance themselves from us. A number of participants were friendlier and had a conversation with Priscilla and Sam. These participants were more likely to give more than one restaurant recommendation. They also discussed what type of food each restaurant served and even which restaurants to avoid.
We discovered that eye contact and body angle were actually dependent on gender and groups. Male targets showed more of these immediacy behaviors towards Sam than towards Sam's female partners, and women did the same with both Trina and Priscilla. Because of this, there was no significant difference between eye contact made or body angle between the white couple versus the interracial couple. However, there was a statistically significant difference between the distance participants created between the white couple and the interracial couple. Participants felt comfortable standing close to the white couple but distanced themselves further from the interracial couple. When analyzing the restaurant recommendations, we found a marginal significance between couples. The white couple received more recommendations for more expensive restaurants than the interracial couple. There was also a positive correlation between the modern racism scale and social distance scale, indicating that a higher score on the modern racism scale led to a higher score on the social distance scale. Also, when looking into other variables, we determined that Republicans had significantly higher scores on the modern racism scale than Democrats that took part in the survey. However, when comparing the two political parties against the social distance scale, there was no significant difference. We found no significant correlation between age or gender on both the modern racism and social distance scales.
Since Colorado Springs is predominantly Republican, we speculated that there is a correlation between the results of the two scales in our field study. Republicans scored higher than Democrats on the modern racism scale, and there is a positive correlation between the modern racism scale and the social distance scale. We speculated these scores affect the distance participants kept between them and the interracial couple. Therefore, we speculated that in real-world settings, it can be assumed that more conservative people are more likely to be prejudiced towards interracial couples. The practical implication is that because Colorado Springs is a conservative city, the field study would reveal adverse racism.
In summary, we found that participants did exhibit different implicit behaviors when interacting with interracial couples versus white couples. However, we did expect to see more difference in immediacy behavior between the participants and the couples. Instead, the only significant behavioral difference was distance, and the variation between restaurant recommendations was only marginally significant. We believe this may have been the case because of a small sample size. The questionnaire revealed that attitudes towards interracial couples are far from perfect. Racist perceptions towards interracial couples are far from extinct.
A future study could address the differences between Colorado College's campus and the citizens in downtown Colorado Springs.
Our students and faculty are, I think, less likely to express the kind of behavior that you might see expressed downtown in terms of different information given to the interracial couple or different ways in which the information is given to the interracial couple.
I would think of, maybe it's a hope, it would be less so. Yeah. Less of a difference, that you'd find fewer variations in responses.
While it is clear that our society has a ways to go, it is evident on and off campus that prejudice faced by interracial couples is on the decline.
Now